Welcome to helpingtesters.com. In this session, we are going to learn in detail about how to record a web application using the WebHTTP protocol and various recording options available with the WebHTTP HTML protocol. Let's look at what we can do with this. As we see in our previous session, just to create how to create a WebHTTP protocol. So let's start with the WebHTTP protocol for recording a functional flow. So I'm just selecting WebHTTP protocol, WebHTTP HTML protocol here. So I'm just naming it as a demo script. So my script will be saved under C drive under script folder. So let's create. We have already seen what is the use of various controls available in this virtual user generator protocol. Let's look at how to record a protocol. See, in our previous session, we have discussed record button is used to record the particular webflow whatever we want to script using this WebHTML protocol. Let's launch. So you can alternately either you can click this or alternately you can click, you can use a keyboard shortcut R, Control plus R. So ideally let's go with the record with this. So I just clicked on the record button. So as soon as you click on the record button, it will launch a window, so which will be asking some basic inputs from you to start your recording. So let's look at the very first one is record into action. So you can here select VUser init action and VUser init. So what are these? As we discussed in our previous session, so these are comes from here. So these are the various default actions available which has been already created by the virtual user generator, VUser init action and VUser init. So if you select whatever the option that you select, though whatever the script that generates will be get into this particular action. So I'm selecting the defaultly as action. So whatever the steps I'm recording, everything will get into the action method. And here you can select which browser that you want to use. Either it may be the browser, or if you want to select any Windows application, or if you want to use the load run as a proxy, or if you want to do something else. So don't worry about all these options at the moment. Just since we want to record the web application, right? Just select the web browser. And the next option that we have is, so since you select the web browser, right, it would be asking for which particular web browser that you want to record. So here I have various browser options that are available. So by default, Internet Explorer, which comes with the Windows machine. So as a first priority, it is showing the Windows Internet Explorer. And along with that, by default, LoadRunner will comes with the Firefox, which is already installed in the LoadRunner installation directory. We will look at about it later, but if you want to go with the Firefox browser, you can select. And if you have installed a Chrome, if you want to record using the Chrome browser, you can select that respective browser here. So all the available browsers that you can select, if the particular browser is available, so it will show up here. Otherwise, you can go with default Internet Explorer and make sure that whatever the application that you are planning to record should support the respective browser that you're selecting. Okay, so let's get it. And the other field, URL address. So this is the one where you input what is the first page that you want to start with the respective application. So here I'm using a demo application, demo.catalan.com. So this is one of the sample applications that we have available on the internet. So here I'm giving, you need to give the complete address of the way, the very first page where you want to start. So this is my first page, and you have two options. So one is the immediately and another one is the delay mode. So if you select the immediately, so once you click on start recording, immediately the browser launch and it will start recording from the moment when the browser launched. So if you want to go with this option, so it will immediately record all the traffic as soon as the browser launch. So here if you select the in delayed mode, so though your browser launches, it will not immediately start the recording unless until you need to explicitly go and enable the recording option once your browser is launched. So some people prefers to use this. So let me go ahead and use the immediately mode. So since I've given to start my, I'm instructing the my browser to already, as soon as you launch, just go and open this application URL. So that's why I don't want to put any delay as soon as the browser launch. And this is a working directory, so we will look at about it. So all the your script temporary, whatever the temporary files that have been created here for your script, so will be saved under this working directory. So we don't need to worry about it. So we don't want to change it. Let's go with that and just say click on record. Okay, just before getting into this, so there is one more option called record options. Okay, so let's get into it. Just I'm not going to show in detail of it as of now. Just I would like to go and show only one option for this based on the browser that you select. So if you select mapping and filtering, so this is the one option which will be useful if you are not able to record properly and everything. So you can select the network level of settings. Either you want to select only WinINet interface on your Windows machine, or if you want to select socket level information. So based on the settings, the level of traffic is being captured by the load runner. So here right now I'm just selecting socket level and WinINet level data capturing. So you don't need to worry about what are the options available here. I will take you through in our further sessions. Okay, so just keep in mind, just okay, whenever you try, since it is a very basic session that I'm covering, so you just go and select WinINet and socket both together. Now just say click, so that window will be disappear. So now let's go and just say start recording. And there is one more important thing. Since we selected Internet Explorer, right, so we should not be already having any instance of Internet Explorer already opened, because if it is already open, your load runner recorder will not identify the whatever the new browser instance that is launched, because the browser proxy will not be diverted through the load recorder. So that's why make sure that, so whatever the browser that you are trying to record with, make sure that it is not already open. So let's go ahead and record it. So the browser will be automatically launched here. Yep, so and it will also open whatever the browser, whatever the application that we have instructed to open. So it is automatically launching that whatever the application that we have given, demo or .catalon.com. So it is opening the browser, and make sure that before you're trying to perform any action on the browser, you must wait until this browser loading completes. Okay, otherwise we may be missing a couple of requests from the browser. Okay, so once you started recording, so it will launch a GUI, it will launch a recorder window for you. Okay, so let me take you through what are the various options. So once your script is completed, you must click on stop. Okay, so then your script will be generating and your browser will be closed. Okay, and your script generation will start. And if you want to do some debug whenever you're trying to record, unfortunately, let's say some feature is not working, or if you want to make sure that that particular debug process is not being recorded by the load runner, so in that case you just go and click on this pass. Okay, so if you want to resume back your recording process instead of stopping, just click on this record, so it will resume, and this will cancel the recording. Means it will not, whatever the request that have been captured so far, everything will be aborted. So just the difference between stop and cancel. So this will once you click on the stop, it will generate whatever the request it captured so far, and if you say cancel, it will not generate any script for you. And here, since we selected our recording pointer in the recording options, see, we asked the VueGen to record everything into action. So it has started, it has highlighted, and it is showing that okay, I'm recording everything into action method. Okay, and this is for creating any new action. So I will cover about it a bit later. And this is the for the start transaction and end transaction. And this is for creating any renderverse point. We will also get into more details about it later. And this is one of the very frequent that we use, the insert comment. Make sure that once you started your recording process, you are always giving a comment for whatever before each and every step that you're taking on the browsers. Let's say I'm trying to click on the make an appointment step now. So what I'm trying to do is just I'm giving a hint for that. I'm going to click on the make appointment. So I'm just writing the command here. Okay, click make appointment. Okay, so I'm just clicked in it. So I'm just clicking on this make appointment. So now we are on the next screen. See, one thing if you observe, so as soon as we are into the other page, or as soon as any page has been loaded, so Okay, while the page has been loading, you will see these number of events have been increasing. So in the previous session, in the previous page, whenever we were in the previous page, we were approximately at 200 plus events. Now it has gone to 400 and plus events. So this means if you see the events are increasing, so that means you are able to capture the traffic. Okay, so if you're still one, though you are navigating through the application, if still events are not recording for the different set of pages, though you're navigating, so it means your recording process is not going in a right way. So though you stop the script, it will not generate any script for you. Okay, so now let's get into other step. Okay, so here we need to fill the entries, username and password. So for this applications we have already here. So what I as I just previously, so we must give any comment before we are making any action on the browser. Okay, so here I'm giving login step. So I'm giving input for username and also password. So now I'm going to click on login button. So as I just said, you must wait until the page load completes. If you look at here, so it is not this role is not continuing. So since the page loading has been already completed, so we don't need to worry about to give any comments now. So let's get into other steps. So here I'm going to select some of the options from here and any options, one more option from here, and I'm going to click on the book compartment. So let's look at, just I'm typing, I'm giving the comment as fill inputs. Okay, just I'm randomly selecting one of the option, and I'm selecting the apply for hospital readmission, and just I'm selecting Medicaid. I'm just selecting the visit date. Let's select somewhere in 22nd and just giving comment. Okay, this is a demo appointment. Okay, just I'm clicking on the book appointment. Okay, and after that I'm going to click on go to home page. So I'm giving up comment for it. And just say log out and make sure that for each and every step that you're trying to do, you must give a proper comment. So I'm going to log out. So there is one more thing which I would like to also explain. So just by looking at, okay, we are sometimes we need to make sure that, okay, whether the application or a virtual user generator is able to capture the application traffic or not. So we are depending on this events, right? Sometimes we also need to cross-check with, you just need to go back, you need to go to the recording log. So we have already seen about this recording log in our previous session, what it contains. I have already explained. So just look at your recording log, and it would be showing something, some data, and it will be showing something like it has been recorded and it has been generating some events, and you will be finding the URLs that whatever you have visited. So this is the way you can make sure that you are able to capture the recording. Let's get back to the browser. So once your recording process is done, just I need to say log out. Okay, once your recording process is done, okay, you need to say click on stop. Now it will generate the recording process. Sometimes the browser will automatically close, or sometimes you need to close it explicitly. So don't worry about it. So now it will generate. So far, if you seen, there was a wizard coming up showing that script is generating. Okay, so now the script has been completely generated, and we will look at all the respective application URLs will be available here. And I was just showing some comments, right? So those comments will be shown up here. So comments can be found out by dot slash star. Say this is the one of the comments that I have given as a very first step. So likewise, you can all the comments will be shown here. So why we need to give the comment here? Just one important question. See, if you don't give any comments, we cannot segregate the respective actions for each and every page. Let's say we have launched the application demo.catalan.com. So if you don't give comment, so login steps and everything will come together as a single entity, or we don't identify whether this request belongs to one particular page. Okay, so this is very basic way of recording the any app, any web applications. So let me take you through the, in our next session, let me take you through the other advanced options available for recording using the various browser. Thank you.